Growing up.
Growing in integrity.
Dignity for all.
A million thanks for still being with us. You're still on to Growing Up. Thanks to our sponsor, Sir Dr. Valentine Atta. Can we give him a round of applause? For comments, contributions, and sponsorship, please call the number displayed on the screen or like the Facebook page displayed on the screen. I call on the first supporting speaker from the opposing team.
I would like to stand on the existing protocols, still opposing the motion that says indoor air pollution is posed a more serious threat to human public health than outdoor air pollution. I heard my opponent saying that death is our generator, that the fumes that comes out of generator makes death. It results in the acute effect. Whereas outdoor air pollution that comes out, the fumes that comes out from the generators result in chronic death and not acute death. Acute death is more low, while the chronic death is more high. Let's move on. Talking about the global warming, my honorable opponent, I want to let you know that outdoor air pollution is of more serious threat than indoor air pollution. This is because it is being spread all over. Spreading all over means that it is widely spread. It is not just in the very immune place like indoor air pollution that is being in a particular place. Outdoor air pollution is everywhere. Take for instance the River State carbon salts that happened. It happens in everywhere. It happens to so many people. It affected the livestock. It affected the infrastructure. It affected humans. Not only the conserved people like indoor air pollution, but it was everywhere, affecting both lives, human beings, and even the water sources that we drink. Talking about the acid rain, I heard my opponent saying, acid rain is as a result of excess carbon, sulfur dioxide, and nitrogen dioxide that is being present in the atmosphere. When this compound forms in the atmosphere, they join with the water molecules in the atmosphere, and they fall as acid rain. Now, this acid rain is very toxic to health. It's very toxic to humans. It causes so many respiratory infection, cardiovascular infection, and so many pulmonary diseases, chronic diseases that affect human as a whole. Not only that, it also affects the soil, the livestock, and even the plants that we as humans take in as food. It affects them because the nutrient that is from it is being taken in by the plants, and after the growth of plants, what happens is that when the plants it produces food. This human being takes in the fruit, and as a result, it also affects us.
Please, I want to ask Mr. Speaker, or my speaker, do we have gases in the atmosphere within the outdoor environment?
Of course.
Very good. Now, whenever some of these pollutants, as you say, comes in contact with the outdoor environment, will some of the gases within the outdoor absorb some of it?
It will absorb, but higher rate of it will.
Thank you. It therefore means the percentage of absorbance has made that particular gas to be diluted. But we talk about indoor air pollution here. It is highly concentrated. There is no gases within that has been able to dilute or absorb some of it. Indoor air pollution is highly concentrated because it is within the
indoor environment. Sir, we are talking about public health here. It is a crowd and not individual, as you said. Indoor air pollution is only constrained in a particular house. That particular person that is living in that house, whether they are two or three, they are constrained in that house. It is not outdoor, that is everywhere. Outdoor air pollution is everywhere. People enjoy it. Thank you. Now, let's talk about the food insecurity aspect of it. Now, you agree with me that in Niger Delta development, there is outbreak of petroleum produce. And this produce is as a result of the gases and the combustion processes that arises from these factories and refineries that you find. This makes it difficult for us as humans that stays around there to be infected. And it causes heart failure, it causes chronic diseases, difficulty in breathing, and a lot more. Okay, take a look at the research has also said that California as of 2018 records that there is a lot of forest fire outbreak, and this forest fire outbreak, it affected a lot of people in that society. It affected a lot of people around the vicinity, and as such, it is rather outdoor air pollution that poses more serious threats than indoor air pollution. With this few points of mine, I believe I'm able to convince you that outdoor air pollution is poses more serious threat than indoor air pollution.
Growing in integrity,
dignity for all.
Are you motivated?
Motivated, motivated, motivated.
Stopping pollution is the best solution. We'll go on a break. We'll be right back.
Growing up is an educative program for the teenage and the upcoming generation.
Growing Up is a program that promotes value-based education and noble moral standards in the upcoming generation, as they are the leaders of tomorrow.
What has this civilization really done? Civilization.
They have gone for competition. We have won. You have gone for competition. Have you won?
Growing Up, a debate special and unique.
Growing Up, raising young minds for the future. For inquiries and sponsorship, please call 0806-429-4907.
For comments and contribution, do like our Facebook page on www.facebook.com/greenup.debate.
Growing Up, a must watch for everyone.
Many thanks for still being with us. You're still on to Growing Up. For comments, contribution and sponsorship, please call the numbers displayed on the screen, or you may like the Facebook address displayed on the screen. Growing in integrity,
dignity for all.
The second supporting speaker from the proposing team, the floor is yours.
Standing on existing protocol, my name is Bright Elijah, a student from the Faculty of Arts, Wakayim State University. I'm here to propose an emotion that says that indoor air pollution is a more serious threat to public health than outdoor air pollution. The introduction of chemicals which are toxic into the atmosphere in the air indoor is indoor air pollution. No wonder in 1992, World Health Organization says that indoor air pollution in developing countries is one of the four most critical global environmental problems. Now, what are the causes of this indoor air pollution? Reduce ventilation. If you look around this studio, you will find that there is no way that air can diffuse out of this place. What if insecticide or air freshener is being sprayed in this place? The chemicals from that air freshener or pesticide will be more harmful to us that are inside this place than the people that will be outside the outdoor environment. Another cause of indoor air pollution, the use of synthetic materials for building, the use of chemical products and household chemical products like pesticide, mosquito repellents, even a furniture polish and shoe polishes. The use of cooking gas, firewood, charcoal, cow dungs, and biomass gas for cooking and generating heat in the house. The effects of indoor air pollution cannot be compared to the effects of outdoor air pollution to the human health. Now let's look at the death rate. In 2018, an environmentalist, Sarah Friday, conducted a research which shows that 3.5 million people die every year as a result of indoor air pollution. Now, can you compare this to the statistics that it showed that 500,000 people die each year as a result of outdoor air pollution? I bet you can't. How about a statistics shown by Indian Journal of Community Medicine, which shows that 2.2 million people die prematurely each year as a result of indoor air pollution? What is the cause of this death? 44% is being caused by pneumonia, 54% is being caused by chronic pulmonary disease, and 2% is being caused by lung cancer. And guess what? The most affected group of people are the women and the children. Why are they the most affected group of people? It's because they spend almost 90% of their time in the air indoor. Hold on, please. They spend 90% of the time in the indoor environment. A child at the age of 3 is being expected to start school. And then once this child gets to the school, where does the child stay? The child stays in the classroom. I put it to you that there are particulate matters in the classroom. And once this child inhales this particulate matter, it leads to sometimes brain damage. Please.
Thank you. You said 1992 statistics, as you stated. But are you aware of the industrial evolution that has led to outdoor air pollution effects? 1992 statistics is too old, and you're stating, like you are in the university, you're citing some cases, but without appropriate authorities, say 52%, what's your source? Now, I also want to ask you, you are giving us the activities like the shoe polishing, and you say that this room is not well ventilated. Are you aware that we have, are you aware of the mechanism behind the air conditioning? Now, the quality of air you have inside is from the air condition is what happens outside. It's what the air condition is taking in what happens outside. So you can't tell me that the room here now is not ventilated. So act smartly. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I said 1992. The statistics I gave was from Sarah Freddy's research of 2018. The second one I gave was from an Indian journal of 2014. Now you're talking about the AC in this place. Are you aware of the chemicals behind the AC? Are you aware of the effects? Now, you won't compare the air you're breathing inside, the quality of the air you're breathing inside this room, and the quality of air you're breathing outside. Come on, check yourself. When you came in, you felt more comfort. When you were outside, you felt more comfortable than when you're inside here. I have to find myself in this room. Why? I'm feeling dizzy somehow. Because there are no proper ventilations in this place. Thank you very much. Also, tobacco smoke. In a research by Sarah Freddy of 2018, not properly, she observed that tobacco smoke is the first leading cause of lung cancer when it is being done in the indoor environment. Now, this is more harmful to the passive smoker. Why? Because the passive smoker inhales over 4,000 chemicals, of which are carcinogens. And you know what carcinogens are? They cause lungs. Apart from causing lungs, these chemicals also trigger asthma. These chemicals also cause burning of the eyes, the throat, the ass, and they even lead to death. Now, for my other hand, this carpet in this place beautifies the home. Carpet, it beautifies these offices, yes. But you are you aware that there's a gas that emits from this carpet without our knowledge? What do they do? If they cause cataracts, I know what cataracts is. If it is not treated properly, then lead to total blindness. Apart from that, it causes asthma. Now, there's been a research according to World Health Organization of 2018. As at 2001 and 2012, research showed that 5.6% of people in the world have asthma as a result of indoor air pollution. Now, by 2014, the number increased to 8.4%, and as of 2018, the number increased to 11.1%. Can you compare that to the severity of outdoor air pollution to human health? My co-debaters and everyone present, I hope I've been able to convince you that indoor air pollution poses a more serious threat to public health than outdoor air pollution. Remarkable. Another round of applause, please. The second supporting speaker from the opposing team. What is your stance? Please make your point heard.
Good day, the chairman and the moderator. Please permit me to stand on this distinct principle. My name is Edijon Sam Elijah, student from the Faculty of Environmental Studies, University of Uyo. I'm here to further oppose the motion that indoor air pollution. I'm here to further oppose the motion that indoor air pollution is a serious threat to outdoor air pollution than outdoor air pollution, with the following point of mind. Complexity in the nature of the pollutant, that is of outdoor air pollution. Identification and control, high cost of control, variation in terms of the time spent. And these effects are felt through the respiratory health effects of traffic and industrial pollution, respiratory health effects from molds and pollen, respiratory health effects from organic emission, volatile organic exposure, health effects from reproductive and developmental problems, effects through extreme weather condition, and even global damage. I want to define to you that threat is defined in the concept of how massive, how large, how spread it affects the lives and properties. Now, you're stating to me that indoor air pollution is between a confined area. Thank God we've been here for more than, for some minutes now. We did not die in this room since you said that there's no ventilation. Your colleague stated that paint, the gases from paint or the substance from paint affect the health. How many years, like how many times do you paint your house? It's once in 3 years. But come to discover activities like your waste disposal, activities like the things you do outside. We tend to be more careless to our outside environments than the inside environment. You take care of your home. You avoid those things that are dangerous and injurious to your health. But outside, you dump anywhere.
What of the exposure of these gases that affect our waterways? What about the masses of persons that are digging boreholes? We no more have private public boreholes again that we take water from, but through private boreholes. And most of these gases tend to sink. Acid rain, as my colleague said. Now look at the massiveness. I'll take that in the minutes. Look at how massive and in outdoor air pollution activities are to the health as compared to indoor air pollution activities. Now you come to discover that indoor air pollution activities can be controlled and identified, but the outdoor air pollution activities cannot be controlled and identified. It's so massive that it kills life and property. Statistics stated in California, 4,000 people died at a spot. The smoke event in London, people died massively. So can you now equate or tell me that indoor air pollution is more severe than outdoor air pollution? I take your question.
My speaker, I heard you talk about or opposing the fact that paints, that how many times do I paint my house? That
yes,
even
sir.
If I paint once a year,
yes,
that the house is not, the chemical in paint is not more serious to the health of humans. But according to Eze, 2016, it clearly stated that the process whereby the gas comes out from paint is called off gassing. And also, it clearly stated that paint, the gas has two concentrations. That the first concentration lasts for 72 hours. That one is called high concentration. While the low concentration lasts for more than 5 years. Are you aware of that? Please make more research on it.
End of point of information.
Yes.
You said end of point of information. You said your paint activity. Now, you don't move into your house immediately after painting the house. Those are the safety measures you have from your professional, the painting, those that paint, your painters. You don't move into your house immediately after painting the house. And also, it takes you 2 to 3 years. Do you know that there are other room furnishing materials like or that like the tiles? People hardly use paint, my dear, nowadays. Now I move on. There are other activities in the environment that affect most severely. Outdoor air pollution is massive. You can't control. You can't even identify. If it happens here now, if acid rain happens here, it corrodes your roof and it can kill millions of persons at the spot. So I am talking to you on the grounds that outdoor air pollution effect is magnitude. It spreads so far. It affects even the lives and property, even the ecosystem. It depicts and stops many things. I want to conclude that you would not say that our indoor air pollution activities cannot be. You can identify if someone is asthmatic. If someone is asthmatic in your house, you want to fry, you tell the person to walk outside. If someone is smoking and you are uncomfortable, you can move away. Even in this room now, very soon we are leaving. So I want to tell you and educate you that outdoor air pollution is massive. It poses great threats to our lives and property. And we can work together to coordinate the activities and work towards a sustainable development of our resources, even putting together things to save the life and property of our people. I hope that with this point of mine and a reply speech from my lead speaker, you will be educated, you would conform, you would understand that outdoor air pollution is more severe, it's massive, and it kills a long run as compared to indoor air pollution.
That was exceptional. Another round of applause for her. Speakers, please adhere to your time frame strictly. We'll go on a break, we'll be right back.
What a sense of pride, what a fulfillment for every parent when you have a child who is articulate, who speaks logically and stands out. That's what NTA Channel 12 Uyo wants to achieve with the program Growing Up, so that indeed, as leaders, not just of tomorrow but for today, can start grooming them to be able to speak logically, to be able to gain confidence, which will make them truly our leaders for a better Nigeria. So join the group on NTA Channel 12 Uyo. It's a platform for an articulate and a leader speaker. Join us all the time.
Growing Up is an educative program for the teenage and the upcoming generation.
Growing Up is a program that promotes value-based education and noble moral standard in the upcoming generation, as they are the leaders of tomorrow.
What has this civilization really done? Civilization.
We have won. You have won for competition. Have you won?
Growing Up, a debate special and unique.
Growing Up, raising young minds for the future. For inquiries and sponsorship, please call 0806-429-4907.
For comments and contribution, do like our Facebook page on www.facebook.com/growingup.debate.
Growing Up, a must-watch for everyone.
A million thanks for still being with us. You're still on to Growing Up. Growing in integrity,
dignity for all.
It's time for the reply speech. And the lead speakers should note that this is another opportunity for them to express their views. And I call on the lead speaker from the proposing team.
I am still Umar El Nathan Isaiah. Please permit me to stand on the already established protocols. My dear opposers, there is one thing I want to put clear to you today, that indoor air pollution is just like a subset. It's just like a universal set, of which outdoor is its subset. You also understand with me that indoor air pollution is highly concentrated, whereas outdoor has been diluted. So my dear opposers, I heard you talk about that indoor air pollution, that the effect of indoor air pollution can be managed, whereas the effect of outdoor cannot be managed. You're very wrong. What about radon leakage that comes out naturally from the ground? Can you just manage anything that is managed naturally from the ground? I also heard you talk about the statistics about fire outbreak in the forest, without giving me statistics. But there are so many statistics that show that the percentage of indoor is more than the one of outdoor. Also, are you aware why there are programs all over the radio on the prevalence of cancer? Is it not because of indoor air pollution? Also, you talk about you said that paint is not that severe, but why is sulfuric acid abnormality, something that's supposed to be present in the urine of animals, not human? Why is it present in the urine of humans? Is it not because of the volatile organic compound present in the chemical used in production of paints? Why do cleaners and disinfectants complain of headache, dizziness as a result of cleaning a house? Is it not because of those chemicals? How about cancer? Why are people often diagnosed with cancer? Is it not attributed to indoor air pollution as one of its factors? Why respiratory problems all over? How about fumes from generator? You talk about acid day. You talk about acid rain. Who has died as a result of acid rain? And when last did acid rain fall here in Nigeria? Also, you talk about fumes from generators. Let me make this point clear to you, that fumes from generator within the indoor environment is more severe than the one of outdoor environment. So my dear opposers, I've been able to draw your attention, say reasons with me why I hold strongly to the motion that indoor air pollution is the most serious threat to public health than outdoor air pollution.
I know you've learnt a thing or two. Thanks to a sponsor, Sir Dr. Valentine Atta. Can we give him a round of applause? Let's hear from you, the lead speaker from the opposing team.
Good day, Mr. Chairman. Please permit me to stand on the already established protocol. I remain Mercy Abasi Frekegret. Seeing, we say, is believing. We can clearly see the effect of outdoor air pollution all around us. But I don't know why we have chosen to remain adamant and to stick to the fact that indoor air pollution poses serious threats to the public health, poses serious threats to you than the outdoor air pollution. I hope you are aware that we have 176 gas flaring sites in the Niger Delta, and these gas flaring sites release 22 million tons of carbon monoxide into the atmosphere. And what does that happen? When that is being converted, it results to 10 billion cubic feet of poisonous and pollutant gases into the atmosphere. Have you ever walked into the abattoir? Have you asked yourself how these meat sellers, they prepare this goat meat? They use tires,
tires, plastics to do what? To burn these goats before bringing them to the market. And what happens? It does what? It pollutes the atmosphere and causes serious harm and threat to these men who kill these goats because they don't even care to wear nose masks or other protective devices on them. How about the 1984 Bhopal in India? The disaster that happened in the gas industry there that killed 3,786,000 people and 186 people were injured. How about 1952 smog in London that killed 4,000 people in just 6 days? So you can see how massive, terrific the outdoor air pollution can be to the public health. It's not something we say kills one person in a matter of hours. It kills millions and thousands of people within minutes, within seconds. So I urge us and I want us to come to the realization that outdoor air pollution poses serious threats to our public health, to you, to our environment than the indoor air pollution. We should not let our environment, we should not let ourselves, we should not let our ecosystem, we should not let our animals, even our infrastructures and monuments, which are equally affected by outdoor air pollution, our bridges to keep up to be swallowed up by smoke and outdoor air pollution. Thank you. Your boy, every kid on earth would love to be a superstar.